Cell lines are the workhorses for cancer research. These groups of cells, which start as samples from patients, are adapted to live and grow in laboratories. Cell lines have proven invaluable to scientists who are working to understand what goes wrong in cells and causes them to develop into cancer. They're also an important resource for identifying new potential cancer treatments. In fact, every drug that doctors use today was tested at one point or another in cancer cell lines.
But for a long time, scientists have realized that there are two issues with cancer cell lines. First, cell lines don't perfectly mimic the tumors they come from and may respond differently to drugs. And second, it's often difficult for a scientist to repeat cell line-based experiments performed by others and get the same results.
We wondered whether the two issues were connected, whether cancer cell lines might evolve in the laboratory just like tumors evolve in a patient.
So we took a systematic look at several samples of two widely used cell lines, one representing a common form of breast cancer and the other representing a common form of lung cancer. Within the cell lines, each sample should have been nearly identical, but we found many, many differences between samples. Point mutations, gains and losses of genes, major changes in gene expression patterns, and more. Those changes affected how the cells reacted to drugs. Some made the cells more sensitive, others made them more resistant.
We kept looking, ultimately studying many more cell lines in culture, and kept finding evidence for cell line evolution in culture. All of this tells us that they are indeed evolving right in front of us in important ways.
So what happens next? Should we discard the cell line as a cancer model? The short answer is absolutely not.
Cell lines are too important and powerful as a research tool to give up. But we have to understand their limitations, and we need to learn how those cell lines change as we work with them in the laboratory.
To address this concern, we've released a free new online tool called Cells Trainer that allows researchers to benchmark a sample of a cancer cell line against a reference sample. If you're about to test a drug on a cancer cell line in your lab, take a moment to check with Cells Trainer that your version of the cell line is valid.
We also think that these discoveries represent a potential new opportunity. The fact that cancer cell lines can evolve in minor ways in culture means that we can exploit these differences between different strains of the same cell line to understand the mechanism of action of new drugs and to learn about their mechanisms of resistance. Cancer cell lines have yielded so many important discoveries that are beginning to benefit patients. Versions of these cell lines exist in virtually every cancer lab on the planet. By understanding these differences between cell lines, we can make cancer research even more reproducible.